Hello, how are you guys? I hope you're having a, thank you so much, a wonderful day. I wanted to come on and do some Reiki to start your week off right. Thank you so much. Thank you. So, if you are new here, welcome. My name is Molly with Sunflower Soul Healing. And I am going to be doing some Reiki today. Reiki is a Japanese healing art, helping to balance and calm your mind, body, and spirit. So just sit back, relax, and receive. You can go ahead and set an intention, whatever it is that you need right now, here in this moment. Maybe that's just simply just to relax. Maybe it's physical or emotional, something you need to release, let go, whatever it is. Set that intention. And as always, I appreciate the likes and the shares when you share. That helps the healing get out to more people, especially those who may not see it. And you never know who might need a little extra support and love today. So, thank you. And of course, if any of my subscribers have anything in particular that you are needing help with, please let me know, especially when I'm in that area of the body. I do have my phone plugged in. So I'm gonna try and leave it plugged in when I do my sound. So let me know if you can hear it. If not, I will unplug it each time, but I'm hoping I won't have to do that. Just let me know though, okay? How it sounds. Good morning. Good morning, Katie. Katie from Texas. Hope you all had a nice weekend. I'm going to go ahead and get started on the root chakra, ground us in, and I'm going to be using my green Tara singing bowl today. So go ahead and take some nice breaths in and just receive. Going to start on your root chakra, which is at the base of your spine. Beautiful red in color. Element is earth, earth energy. Helping with any physical issues. Our hips and below, so our hips, our lower back, our legs, our knees, our ankles, our feet, helping to move move that energy down the lower part of our body. When our root chakra is balanced, we feel grounded, we feel anchored. We feel calm and balanced. Hip pain and some emotional lower back and hip. Okay, well, I will work on that. And yeah, so this week, let's talk about if you woke up this morning and you're like, ooh, I'm feeling a bit tired or maybe a little bit emotional. Yeah, this week is one where we might be feeling more of that energy. We have the new moon. 16th. And so if you are feeling some of that, just honor it and let go. Helping you to feel, yeah, grounded and clearing out any heaviness or anything you might be holding here in the root. Any worry, anxiety, any fear energy. We can hold a lot and store a lot of emotional energy in our hip area, in our hips. We can feel a lot and hold a lot of stored emotions there. The root is all about our survival needs. So everything very physical, you know, in this world. So when we worry about our job or our finances, if we're in a state of transition, if we're moving, when we feel like we're just standing on shaky ground where nothing feels when we really want to work on that root. That earth energy helping us to slow down. Helping us to slow down. And kind of growing roots from the soles of our feet into the earth, really anchoring us in times of change or energy that feels a little chaotic. Right now there's a lot of that earth energy going on in our planet. You know, a lot of fires and kind of disruption. Starting school, going away to college. So whatever that is, know that you are supported and just be right here in this moment. Not looking too far ahead, focusing on things in the past, but just right now, and even if it's just before you scroll, just for these few moments I'm talking to you. So really grounding, clearing this out, moving any energy you might be holding in that lower back. And sometimes that lower back area can be, from an emotional standpoint, feeling supported. So sometimes if you feel like you're carrying the weight of the world on your back, if you feel like you don't feel have a lot of support. Sorry, there's some big, I think last time, I'm gonna have to think of a symbolism for this. Last time I was on my live, it was really nice and calm, and a garbage truck came in and it was noisy. I don't know if you guys can hear that, but, and I was like, what is, and then I was like, ooh, emptying our mind. All the trash and all the clutter that we have, letting our mind be free and empty. Well, I'm like, what the heck is that noise? It's a street cleaner. It's a street cleaner. I don't know if you guys can hear that. Maybe that's helping to clear our path, helping to clear, clear our pathway. Starting something new, clearing all the old out, clearing all the old, all the dirt and grime and things that no longer serve you. Yes, 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 okay. There we go. Because with this new moon, this is a time right now more about focusing, letting go. More about letting go, releasing all that doesn't serve you. And so when I say if you're feeling a little more emotional, it could be just things coming up to the surface that we need to clear away. Oh, I love that. Thank you, Alex. It's one of my favorites. Thank you. You're in the hospital. Butterfly girl, what are you? Well, let me know what I can do for you, please. Waiting on hematology, oncology for some. Oh, feeling exhausted. Okay, I'm sending to you right now. Sending you so much love. And everyone on this, it's with us, the 505. Ooh, yes, the 5 number. Send Butterfly Girl, send her some love and support. Know that you are so supported here. Just try and relax the best you can. Calm your mind and just receive. Know there's people on here probably all over the world supporting you and sending love to you. let's bring that energy down from our head. When we feel overwhelmed with emotions or anxiety or worry or fear, we can get really caught up in the upper part of our body. We want to bring that energy down. So on that root, yeah, moving, shifting that hip, lower back, helping you to feel in your body, grounded, calm, balanced, and supported in whatever you are going through in this moment. I'm going to do my tuning fork. So this one is more vibration. And you can even put the phone if you want, if you're holding it over each chakra. I do have my phone plugged in, so let me know if you can hear it. If not, I will unplug it. But hopefully you can. I don't know. We'll see. Okay, just let me know. let's play Singing Bowl again. But actually, I'm going to use this is called like a Super 7, and it has 7 different crystals within one, and I want to use that for the, actually I'm going to do it this way, the root. I have to be mindful of my time. I'm going to move up to the sacral. Orange in color. This is our womb space. The element is water energy, helping with any physical issues with our bladder or our reproductive area. Fertility. We can hold a lot of fear energy here. So helping to release that fear of the unknown that can feel scary. We don't know what's going to happen or if we have to wait on things that are out of our control, right? That can feel very overwhelming and scary at times. And that's when we really have to have faith and trust, which can also be scary at times. Yeah. So it's a lot about focusing in on what you do have control over, what you do. So right now, just being, just receiving, knowing that the worrying, of all the what if outcomes, it's not going to change. That's not going to change the result. Okay, so we have to let that go. And focus in on you and what you do have control of. Here in this moment, just being. Focusing on the best outcome. Today, I woke up and it was one of those where I don't know if you guys feel the same. I'm very sensitive to just the energy in general of the planets and the shifting and all of that. And it felt like, have you ever been like super excited? Like I felt like the Lionsgate portal, it was like a big burst of energy and party and like this, woo, yeah, you know, when you've been like looking forward to something or you go on a trip and you're like, yeah, whatever, you know, and then it's like you get home or you have to leave and reality starts and you might feel tight. That was that energy where it's like, gosh, I feel it was really interesting, and even a little bit of more heaviness, but like a sadness a little bit. I don't know, it's really interesting. But there is a shift in Venus right now, and that's focusing on the heart and relationships and all of that, where they say that she's now gone under in into the underworld of kind of like a death and rebirth. So it could be a feeling of more emotions. And right now we still are in our heart space of Leo. So just know that. Gentle with yourself. But then I think it says then it's like on the 21st, it like the star then like you can't see it right now, but then it emerges like beautiful, bright. So yeah, kind of like a transformation period. Helping to clear any worry or fear might be holding here, bringing in new, beautiful, vibrant energy, creating new. So maybe a little more stillness this week. Let's bring in sacral. Energy work and sound as well. It helps to just clear and move and shift the energy that, anything that feels stagnant in that area moves it even more. Ocean jasper. Well, maybe that's why. That ocean energy, that water energy. Sacral, the element is water, cleansing, movement, flow. and also sending healing to the waters of our world, our ocean and Hawaii. That has been, just sending so much love. To the solar plexus, which is the center of our belly, yellow in color, sun energy. The element is fire. Helping to strengthen our solar plexus of our worth, knowing that we are worthy of all the beautiful things in life, our goals, our dreams, our aspirations. And clearing any heaviness here. You can internalize those things. You can really internalize those emotions anywhere, but this is an area, the body, where those emotions can be held. Helping to strengthen so that mid-back area. Helping to calm the heat or the fire, which it's great to have fire energy as long as it is in balance. We want balance. We need all our emotions. We need all of the elements. Each one serves its purpose. It's just when they become out of balance, and just like in nature, it can cause a lot of destruction as well as in our own physical body. This is an area to work on if you're an empath or sensitive. You might pick up on other people's emotions or feelings and not even know it, but then you end up kind of taking those on yourself. So it's clearing anything that is not yours. Having good energetic boundaries, knowing it's not your responsibility to fix everyone's problems, you know? When we're an empath or we like helping others, we really kind of dive into that and wanting to help which is a beautiful thing, but we have to know to have our own energetic boundaries, that it's sometimes it's that person's journey and we can support them through it, you know, but we don't have to get entangled in that drama or that, yeah. I say this a lot, you can't be everything to everybody and nothing to yourself, okay? So refilling that cup, and that's what we're doing now. You're here, replenishing your cup, getting some receiving, some relaxation. To move that energy. Our mind is really powerful, so the things and how we talk to ourselves, it's really important. Ooh, I'm feeling emotional on that one. So not having to be perfect or people please, or talk kindly to yourself. Yeah. And so that's why mantras can be really important. At the beginning, it might feel really strange or uncomfortable, or you're like, I don't even feel this way. You know, it's like, but the more that you do it, your mind, it gets your mind out of that cycle of that, the repetitive negative thoughts. And so, you know, when you are feeling that, you know, just kind of going into, I am worthy, I am secure, I am powerful, I am abundant, I am grounded, I am safe, I am whole, you know, whatever that is. And you kind of go into this flow. Release and let go with ease and grace. I move forward easily. Today, I just keep on hearing, I am worthy. I am worthy. I am worthy. And yes, you are. All right, let's bring in solar plexus. Singing bowl. one thing when I was doing that that came in, it was like our solar plexus is about our personal power. And sometimes when things are out of our control, we can feel powerless, a sense of that. And it's saying, you know, you are, you hold the light. You are powerful, even when everything around you might be swirling and chaotic and out of control. It's like be the center, be the eye, where you can go within yourself and calm your body, your mind, your spirit. You are not powerless. You are a powerful, divine, infinite being. I don't know, that came in really strong when I was playing that, so. Yeah. All right, we're gonna move up to the heart chakra, and this solar plexus might be an area for this week for us to really kind of nurture and love. On feeling. All right. Oh, I don't think I did a crystal. Hold on, sorry. And I'm gonna do howlite because I want to help soothe and calm and relax that solar plexus, that belly. You're welcome, Danny. Yeah, sometimes I feel like things come in, it's like messages, you know? So if it resonates, yeah, it's probably. Howlite is a great calming, soothing crystal, relaxing. Right there, that's where I want to put it. Right there. All right, let's move up to the heart chakra, which is in the middle of our chest area. Opening up that chest space. Roll those shoulders back, drop them. Breathe, clearing any heaviness or stress or anxiety off this area. Clearing that. So that chest area feels more open and lighter, not constricted or tight. The element here is air. I want that air, lightness, freedom. Heart chakra would be an area, well, obviously issues with your heart or lungs, that upper back. Down. Reiki, you can watch me. You can watch and then close your eyes. You can fall asleep. You can listen. It's whatever feels good to you in this moment. That's what you do. As long as you say, yeah, I receive, I'd like some of this, that's all you gotta do. And then just let go and just receive. And it does work on our intention. Always for our highest good. The shoulders, relax your jaw. Again, open that up. Even talk about that, the high heart a lot, even placing your hand here. So if you, again, feel a bit emotional today or this week, that's okay. Let it go, honor it. If you feel tired, more tired than usual, that's okay. Honor it, allow your body to rest. Give yourself permission to rest, to receive, and just be. Let's bring in the tuning fork. And yes, let's see. This week is my birthday. It's my birthday week. I think it's like right on or close to the heart. Thanks, guys. Thanks. I'm gonna bring in some green. Oh, look how gorgeous that is. Green opal. Green opal. Heart chakra energy. Big virtual hug. Yeah, and when you put your hand here, that is, it's kind of like you're giving yourself a hug. Or you can hug yourself. All right, let's play Singing Bowl. Isn't she so beautiful? Green Tara, divine feminine, nurturing energy, compassion, compassion. She has one foot forward, helping to lead, to guide you in the right direction, support. Beautiful. And I'm going to bring in a tuning fork miracle frequency. Up to the throat chakra. Blue in color. Blue in color, ocean, aquamarine. And to keep that space here open. Allowing you to express yourself, your feelings, your truth, what it is that you need. Energy all here on the shoulders as well. Helping with physical, it'd be sore throat or thyroid or neck, back of the neck. Relax that neck side to side. Is your neck stiff? Like if you try and roll it, how does that feel? Movement there. This is an area on all of us that can kind of get stagnant or heavy at times. You to communicate your needs. I want to say effectively, and that doesn't sound very, but you know what I'm saying, be able to communicate and verbalize, you know, what it is that you need. Sometimes we have a hard time, but that also that heard something where it's like, maybe you are an excellent communicator in this listening, hearing. Sometimes it's not about the communication, it's about the comprehension, right? So sending healing, you know, if you do express yourself, okay, but it's not really being received or isn't a comprehension of, does that make sense? I'm trying to say. or easy, it goes on deaf ears. It's just like, you know, it's like, keep on expressing, keep on verbalizing. But if your emotions or your what you need is not being met or open for discussion or how things could change or, you know, then take note of that. Speak to yourself kindly. Clearing any overstimulation, chatter. Overload, input overload. Or any unkind things that you've heard or encountered. Beautiful. All right, I'm going to bring in the throat chakra. Also take note, you know, if you are tight here, if you clench, relax that jaw. Let it just fall. Blue appetite, beautiful blue appetite. So crystals hold a frequency, a vibration. We are all energy. Everything is energy and it's vibrating at different frequencies. And so that's why crystals, they're vibrating at a vibration. So us as human beings, we're up and down, our emotions, this, that, sometimes high, low. And so then when we take a crystal that's vibrating at a consistent energy, then that helps to balance to bring that in our energy field. You know, it's amazing, like just with the crystal quartz. I mean, it's used in watches, in computers, in it has, I mean, it's really amazing if you think about it, you know. Let's go up to our third eye and crown. And again, if you are new here, welcome. Thank you for being here. And just working, just relax that all the tension you hold here. Head space here in your jaw. Allow kind of your neck to lean back here. Reiki is great for calming down our nervous system, relaxing our mind, getting us out of that hypervigilant state, that fight or flight. You might feel tingling, you might feel sleepy or emotions, you might just like it. You might not be able to actually verbalize what it is you like, you just do. So calming that mind so we have clarity and focus. Drain, like when you undo, the bathtub's full, you've washed off all the gunk of the day, and you let that drain and all that water flows down. It's kind of like Reiki, it's like we're clearing all the energy that we've absorbed, the emotions that we've held on to. It's bringing that energy down from our head. It's like pulling the plug. Allowing our mind to be clear and calm, relaxed. Repost this to YouTube. Repost all my lives to YouTube, Sunflower Soul Healing. So you can find it there later today. is clear and calm and relaxed, that's when we can really be in tune with our intuition. Receive that clarity that we need, that aha moment. Sometimes you may notice that when you're in the shower, you have really good ideas, or the aha moment comes in. And yeah, and that's that water energy. It's like the top of the crown, it's clearing, it's moving, and water, there is this energy and it's relaxing, and it's helping to, there's a lot of intuition and creativity and all of that with water. But you might notice that when you're in the shower, you have really good ideas or something. Especially needing help with sleep or stress or anxiety, I am on a new app called Aura. You can find me there. I do meditations, and that link is in my TikTok link tree, and you can click on it and check it out. There's lots of meditations and great services there if you're on this kind of journey or needing help with sleep, anxiety, stress. And there's healthcare, like mental health professionals, like licensed counselors and life coaches and healers and yoga, all sorts of stuff. You can see if you like it. Use it as a tool to help you. I always say, find the voice that you like. So, clearing that crown. Beautiful purple and color, connecting you to all that is, knowing you're all connected, you to me, me to you, to the earth, animals, stars, oneness. The synchronicities in your life. It's not a coincidence. The universe, our angels, our loved ones are always trying to communicate with us. Their communication is just a little different, but we have to be open to see the signs, the messages. Open. Let's bring in the tuning fork first for the third eye. always know my grandmother is around by finding my teddy bears around the house randomly. I love that. Yeah, you know, for all of us, it's like, you know, maybe someone that we love, or even a pet or an animal, it's like there's a symbolism, whether that is a feather or a bird or a butterfly or something, but you know, you can feel it. There's something. It's their way of communicating. And, or maybe it's numbers, or maybe it's a smell, or whatever that is. And a lot of times it can come in times when we really need some support or love. Maybe it's a song, a color. And sometimes we just feel it. It's like, I don't know what that was, but, or it's how the wind blows a certain way, or yeah, you just have to be open. And upbeat when everything's going okay. It's when things aren't, you know. But you gotta find that light and have that hope, and you can do it. And you know, lean on others to remind you when you have forgotten, you know, support. And we all need it, each and every one of us. We all need it. 100%. All right, well, I'm going to do, I'm going to end this. And yeah, if this resonated with you all my information is in my link tree. I do one-on-one distance sessions, or if you live in the beautiful state of Kentucky, come find me. I do in-person sessions, would love to see you. I'm on YouTube, Instagram, and Aura. And hopefully I will be doing lives on there soon. So I'm excited about that. I just did a affirmation for abundance and success, having that like positive mindset. I think a lot of us can have that, like, where, yeah, we, yeah, so it's having, yeah. See that in our life. And just know, please, I will, this came on my other live, I hate that I even have to say it, but there are fake accounts out there. I will never ask for donations or message you or say I feel drawn or do you want a free reading or anything like that. I would love to work with you, but you just got to go through my website to book. And yeah, this is my only account, so if someone, Sunflower Soul, starts following you, just look at, yeah. And then on Instagram, I have the blue check mark, but it's Sunflower Soul Healing on all platforms. Just watch out for the fake scammers. And especially, it was like Reiki, what was it, like heart health, I don't know, something weird. Anyways, I was asking for donations, but be safe. I love you. And I do have to run. I went over as usual, per usual. So I'm always then like, eek, I gotta go. yeah, well, I'll be back on maybe tomorrow. But, oh, yeah, so a big week. I'll just share a big week for me. My daughter is gonna be going off to college. Oh gosh, ooh, that's probably what my heart, like my teary eyes, ooh. So Yeah, so it will be great. I'm so excited. But of course, you know how that is. So, and birthday week. So, yeah, a lot going on. But I will be back on. So, all right.